Hello and welcome to Cooking with Daisy. Today, I'm going to be making a burrito. You may ask, who is this for? Oh, well, my lovely, lovely, lovely participant, the fat man himself, Wario.
Oh, I guess I'm so excited to eat this.
Yeah, he eats almost anything. And, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend you, Wario, but, you eat everything, do you?
Mm-hmm, I do.
Okay, bye. Anything. To start this off, we're going to be batting the eggs. I don't know if that's the right term, but I'm just gonna say it anyways. Well, first, we're gonna use the eggs. We're gonna use grade A golden large eggs. I don't know if that's correct, but whatever. So first we're gonna make sure there's no cracks in any of these. Like this one's good. This one. Three. Perfect. We're also gonna be using milk. Now we're not making scrambled eggs or sunny side up eggs. We're going to be making fluffy eggs. So, for that, we need to bat the eggs. As I said earlier, I don't know if that's a correct term, but whatever. We need a bowl to mix. Oh, bowl. We need a bowl to mix the eggs. So, we need a fork for that. Or a whisk, but I'm gonna use a fork. My lovely fork. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna crack these eggs one by one. Fork off. Okay. Now that we have all the eggs cracked, we want to pour in a small amount of milk. I think I poured a little too much to where it might be a little too watery. What I really like to do is add some salt and pepper and some, I think this is how you pronounce it, cajun. You can put it in after or before. Now, oh god, I can smell it. We're gonna put some pepper, if I can find some. So I got my pepper, and I'm just gonna... That looks like enough. So when you bat your eggs, you just wanna be very, very gentle. Well, not really. You wanna do it at a fast pace. Also, not too hard, because you don't want to fall. You wanna do it in like a circular motion, kind of, I guess. You wanna make sure there's no tiny bits of egg yolk at all. You want it to be crystal clear. Do not overbeat it, because if you do, it's gonna be bad. So just listen to Daisy.
My god, that looks so good! Daisy, can I have some?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, oh my god.
Now don't eat this stuff. This stuff is raw and disgusting. Don't do what Toad did. I let him do it because I don't like him. Okay. I would advise whisking it more than using a fork because it's kind of tiring. Now I think it should be ready. It's kind of soupy, but you know.
Okay, so now that we've finished beating the eggs, we're going to put it in this skillet. First is add butter all around the skillet so that we're able to get the egg onto it without sticking onto it. And also, for it to be super duper delicious,
before we do that, we want to put it to medium heat. We don't want to put it too high or too low.
Okay, now it's time for the butter. So, you want to get one stick out. I can get it. Let me see where it is. Here. Perfect. So we don't need the butter anymore. Oops. Sorry. Let me put it here. So we want to cut it about how much we want to use. So I'd say probably about this much butter. You actually need to use more than that, but I'm going to put more. We're going to use this much more. I turn the fan on because I don't want anything to smoke up and whatever. So now that it's done, we need to pour in our egg. follow these directions very, very carefully. So with your spatula, you want to go around the edges. After a few seconds, probably 30 seconds or a minute, you're going to want to, once the edges start getting a little yellow, you're going to see them grow thicker. That means the egg is ready to fold. Scoop the edges very, very gently. You don't want to break them. You want to do it so that the rest of the egg gets on the other side so it can crest too. If there's no egg, you know, going to the sides, that means you're ready to cut it and to fold it around. It's already looking kind of fluffy. Okay, so as you're waiting, we're gonna wait until, if you can, just scoot it out to the edges, and then you're ready to cut it. Pizza. Oopsies. Now it's time to turn the heat low because it's kind of already getting too hot. Okay, good. You just want to flip it around and, you know, you want them a golden color or something between a yellow brown. So the kitchen's kind of makes the egg a little brown, but if you don't add cajun, it'll just be a yellow golden color. If you burn a little too much with the normal eggs without seasoning, you'll see that it is turning super brown. You can just let it sit there for a few seconds. If it's burning too much, just scoot it to the side and turn the heat down. Touch the skillet, it is super hot. Make sure you don't ever touch it. Unless if you're, actually don't do it.
So it's turning nice golden brown. I think it's honestly kind of getting close to red.
You can call me Daisy Ramsay. I'm joking. Gordon Ramsay would kill me if you ever saw this. Our eggs look ready.
So we want to turn off the heat
and move the skillet to the side. Eggs look nice and ready. So now we're gonna put them on a plate.
Now that we have a plate, we're gonna transfer our eggs from the skillet to the plate.
I might have made these eggs a little too crispy, but I mean, the crispier the better. Just make sure you're keeping an eye on them. Don't be like me. Now it's time to heat up the tortilla. So now that we have the tortillas, we're gonna put them in the skillet. Now, I would advise you to wash your skillet first and actually make sure that there's nothing on it, just because it wouldn't be very wise to put your tortillas and raw egg, you know, on the skillet, but for the sake of this, Wario can eat anything.
He'll eat anything.
Okay, first, turn on the heat to medium again. We don't really care if we put butter or not because it's just a tortilla. Okay, so one tortilla. It's a bit small and you can use a bigger size, or you can use corn tortillas. But if you use corn, I advise you to use either cooking oil, like vegetable oil, or you can use butter. We're just gonna let them sit there and we're gonna flip them after a few seconds or maybe a minute, just so that we know that it's not turning really, really brown. Now that the tortillas are very hot, we're gonna put some cheese on them. I prefer taco-style cheese. We're gonna turn the heat off. Oopsies. Now, I know we're making burritos, but we just wanna make sure that the cheese is good. We want it to be melted.
Wow, I did that.
Off the skillet they go, or off the stove they go. My super sincerest apologies for the tiny little crumbs on the table. Put the egg into the quesadilla. Into the quesadilla. Quesadilla. Whatever. So you can be generous with the amount of mayo you put, but I kind of just put a spoonful,
a new spoon, and put some sour cream in it, or just put it on the side. Now we're gonna put some sour cream. Now one of my favorite things to put on my delicious food is
really good seasoning. Ugh, get over here, you stupid.
Hold on, guys. Just be patient. What are these? Oh, these are gumbo bits. What are gumbo bits, you may ask? They're just a substitute for, for bacon bits. Now it's time to put our gumbo bits onto our burritos. Perfect. Now we're gonna put some egg into our burritos. Okay, time to put our egg into our burrito. I know it looks disgusting, but it is disgusting. He might die. It's okay though. I want him to. This should be a perfect way to totally not kill someone that you totally hate. Oh my god, this is so delicious. Now we're done folding them into a burrito. I know, it's a very poor job of a burrito. It's hard multitasking, okay? Plus, I don't really care about this. This is for someone I really, really, really love. Wink, 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 wink. Here you go, Wario.
Oh. It's a beautiful, beautiful burrito. Oh, I cannot wait to eat it. Oh my god.
Here is your dish, Wario. This is a super duper delicious, healthy, super snackable Montessori, the Cortessori of the Montessori of the New York City. Best selling Egalonc Conquistador, shredded madness of above the heavens. And I made it because I know the recipe.
What is that?
I don't know. I just made it up. But it's super duper good and it's delicious and I promise you, you won't die after eating this.
Oh my god, I cannot wait to eat it. Oh my god. Oh, this is so.
Something that you really, really hate. Thank you so much for watching. All-star recipe that will shoo away the people that you really, really don't like. Thank you so much for following this recipe. If you have succeeded to poison the person that you really hate, tell me in the comments below. Thank you.